That's, that's how old this animal is. So this would have been on a stalk like that, and it would have been a fan, like, you know, like a Japanese fan.
Yeah.
And then on the ends, you can just about see it, those would be the filter feeding polyps, which would have filter feeded in that very shallow ocean on the equator, on the 25 million years ago, filtering the plankton from the water for that organism. That's just one of many fossils that were in the cave.
And then it would have died, found common.
It died, and then it was the weight of the build-up of the lime in the bottom of that ocean would have buried it, and then it would have been crystallised, and you get this structure where the animal, that's not the real animal itself, it's the compartments that are filled with crystalline lime to preserve it, and that's what you're seeing there. So if you look above your heads, you'll notice that the roof is very rippled here. Mm-hmm. What you're actually looking at there is actually a fossilised seabed, but in the reverse. So that's sand that's been fossilised from that warm, shallow sea. And the little bits that you can see in it, that's not rock. Those are dead mollusk shells that have been fossilised on the surface, that floated to the bottom of that ocean all that time ago. Along here is another fossil. Here we go. So that's another.
Oh, wow.
You've got the mountain on David Atom, and they're like little dome holes. Mm-hmm. And they have little polyps that fill through the elbow. That's what that is. It's flat because of the sheer weight of the rock that's been buried in, it's flat in that structure. But you can see the compartments of its body.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There. And then just over here, we have another one. See, you see that little circle, it's like a little ring, just there. That's actually a tube effects worm. So I don't know how familiar you are with tube effects, but it's like a worm the size of a cucumber. Oh,
okay.
About that long. And it has a leathery body that's buried in the sand. And then it comes out and it feeds by opening up a little fan, and it filter feeds like that and captures the plankton from the water and then ducks back in. And it's got a protective mechanism, and as much as if it gets attacked by a predator or a fish, it just shoots back in and closes its little fan, and then it protects itself in that leathery body. So the body is actually buried in the roof of the cave, and you'll see it end on. So it's body will be inside, and then the outer ring is actually the leathery body.
Hidden
inside that tropical reef on sandy bed. So that's what you're looking at there. So there are loads of different invertebrates and corals that are actually fossilised in the whole structure of the limestone cave.